In fact, today's my talk, today's talk will focus on indigenous technology development for the sustainable development or sustainable energy supply. So, in fact, you know that ultimately the energy problem can be solved only with some indigenous technology development, maybe with proper mix of energy sources options or even integration of a couple of sources, ultimately to ensure that the overall system integration is done properly, more effectively. So in fact, the organizers have given me some topic to work on modern and innovative technologies, renewable energy technologies for sustainable development or sustainable energy supply. So in fact, in this talk, I'm going to give some glimpses of the indigenous technology development, especially on, it's not working. I'll try to speak a bit loud, doesn't matter. Okay, I hope you can hear me.
Okay. Yes, just hold it.
No, this light is not on. So, in fact, it's working now. I'll give you some indigenous technologies, that's which we are doing at IIT Madras, so that you'll have some idea how indigenous technology play a major role in attaining the system. You know that there are several problems, and energy is the most important. And if you see that mainly the energy sector is primarily driven across the world, as well as in India, is fossil fuel sources. So therefore, when you try to address the problem of energy, you have to take care of environment as well. Of course, we have several other problems. But out of all these, the first 3 months are most important. So water and energy, food. So therefore, if at all there is some unrest in the society, it will be for these three. And of course, the energy consumption is increasing drastically and exponentially with almost, in India, it's the highest increase, almost 0.9% and of GDP and so on. So therefore, the energy sustainability gives us increase the standard of living and so on. So therefore, if you see the energy sources, there are two types of sources to cater the requirements. One is a celestial or incoming source, the other one is a capital. We primarily dependent on capital source, that means the sources which are exist within the earth. The celestial are the sources which are coming from the outside the space. So if you see the energy reserves, mainly renewables, fossils and nucleus are the major sources for our needs. And if you see any typical energy system hierarchy, you have energy sources and energy carriers and the utility. And if you see the energy sources, the present energy scenarios are seen is driven by fossil fuels. But to a certain extent, the renewables are coming to play. And if you see the global potential of energy, and this is the, I have shown here with the different bulbs. But if you can see that it's a bigger one, which is solar, and of course, it can give the entire this thing to mind. But primarily, we are dependent on this, which results in environmental issues and so on. So if you see, forget about environmental issues, but if you see the lifestyles, these are the blocks which we have with us. And this is the world consumption. The present world energy consumption is this. And if you try to use these blocks, coal, oil and uranium, natural gas, with this rate, they extinguish respectively these days, like these years. But if you see there on the top, you have solar radiation, which is inexhaustible, which continuously cater the requirement of this tiny consumption. And of course, this is translated into different. See, if you environment is a major thing, but energy source is also important. And with the present projections, you cannot see oil in 2056 and so on, gas in another 2070 and so on. India is the fourth largest producer and consumer of coal. We have reasonably abundant coal, but you know that the quality of, we refer as quality and grade. In fact, in spite of having abundant sources, we still import coal from both the east and west east and west. The east coast is from east, like Australia, Indonesia, and South Africa, and so on. But to see however much we import, there are actually we refer as a quality and grade. Indian coal grade is low grade. It's a low grade coal because 40% ash. And whereas we import almost all eastern power plants. In fact, you see that there are several power plants recently set up for massive, ultra supercritical power plants. We import coal from Australia and Indonesia with low sulfur content, about 12%. But the problem is, the quality wise, the coals are not good. Because when we refer quality, it refers to the environment. Grade refers to the energy. So though they have a high energy content, but the quality, environmental point of view, they are not good because they have contains a lot of sulfur. The sulfur pollutes the environment. So therefore, though we import coal because of the economics point of view, but it deteriorates environment significantly. But even we have abundant coal, but still the environment is a major thing. And the coal consumption, the energy consumption is almost becoming doubled in a 30-year span. If you see 73 to, given a statistics about 6,000 million tons of oil equivalent to 12,000, it is almost taking is energy, environmental degradation, population are all in the same way, almost 30 years of doubling time and so on. You can see the environment also, it becomes double, the environment means environmental degradation. And in India's power sector is rapidly growing with a higher rates and primarily fossil fuel based, mainly coal. Coal is a major thing. That's why if you consume more coal, you have more environmental problems. Just now I mentioned that it's almost 30 years of doubling time of environmental degradation, especially carbon emissions. And of course, there's appropriate effects and of the carbon emissions. And then there's an environment, energy environment, society interactions also important. They are closely interacted and with a great influence and so on. And the technology, what we are talking about technology. Technology is a major role. It plays a major role in both environment side as well as energy side. And the recent technologies, we call it, I refer as an NBC, nano, bio, information, cogno, and energy technology. These are the five technologies gaining momentum to cater the needs of the energy and needs as well as in an environment. And there are, of course, you have energy drivers and goals, and they are closely related. And we call 6A criteria as far as the energy is concerned: accessibility, affordability, acceptability, adaptability, appropriateness, and assurability. Because when any energy source fulfills these 6A criteria, it makes the system more sustainable and so on. Of course, all this, what is at what cost? The present cost is coal, oil, gas, and nuclear. So this is the present scenario in order to attain your energy goals and drivers. And a comprehensive technology approach can fulfill the needs or makes the system better. That includes both your renewables, biofuels. In fact, reduction in transmission distribution lines, carbon sequestration, clean, the new nuclear energies, and net zero buildings. Building sector is one of the largest energy consumer, and of course automobiles. So one has to address all these sectors in a most appropriate way, in an integrated way to achieve the energy sustainability. In fact, there are several bottlenecks for energy supplies and for reliable energy supplies. You have wide variety of these. There's a domestic unrest, market deregulation, energy price volatility, geopolitical instability. There are many things, of course, all this. Transportation bottlenecks and so on. What is the disparity between the energy consumption across the world? We classify into developed and developing countries. You know that 80% population of a developing country consumes only 40% of the energy, whereas 20% of population consumes 60% of that. And of course, there is a high disparity as far as the energy consumption. If you talk about environment, first talk about energy. So whether we have enough energy or not, then only you can think of environment. So I have given here, shown a list how there is a comparison between India, China and US, and you can see any indicator, they are not even close to that. Even if you compare neighboring countries, Indian energy consumption, per capita energy consumption is not at close. What are the issues actually? What are the problems? Why we have such a disparity? I refer to this as a four step, or four, I classified into four factors or causes. One is a technological cause, managerial cause, and economic and structural causes. And mainly the technologies have to be developed indigenously, and they have to maintain and manage properly. And they all, in order to implement these technologies, you should have enough resources also, economics, and we have to make them more effectively to penetrate into the society. And if you see, there are a lot of changes in the international energy context, of course, which I have just now mentioned, there are major issues here. There, if you see the energy sector from 2007 to 2035, mainly, if summary of this is, fossil fuels continue to be a major source of fuels. But there is a significant role or importance for renewable energies, and definitely over a period of time, renewable energy gains a larger share of the energy supply. There are several energy scenarios. Mainly, when we project the energy scenarios, many scenarios means alternative images. We have to consider various things. Generally, when we come up with an alternative scenario, these some 8-9 factors are, have to be considered, especially population projection, economic prospects, change in energy efficiency. You know that the energy efficiency is significantly improved. You see, any energy conversion system, 20, 30 years back, the efficiency is different, and now present it is different. Classic, there are several classic examples. And how do you shift from one fuel to the another fuel? Whether if you shift from fossil to renewables or renewable to fossil, and at what cost and what location and so on. And how do you penetrate this technology? Because you know the classic technology penetration, cell phone is cell phone, automobile. In Indian automobile sector is, of course, is rapidly growing, and every week you can see a new model and so on. So, and of course, how do you tackle the environment? How do you tackle environmental problems and so on? And of course, money is required for this. And then one, ultimately, the energy sources which are depleting, we have to push them up by implementing various measures so that the energy can be last for a longer period of time. And this is a picture which you show, the energy demand and prosperity, where you have the high illuminated, that means you have energy prosperity, energy prosperity, high demand, but there is less illuminated. We call it energy poverty. So that you can see here in some of in this map, some of the countries are missing, and here you see these. That means this region, even the south region, several hundreds of millions of people do not have electricity, even accessibility to electricity. Even several millions of people are still dependent on the primary energy. Primary energy means for cooking purpose is still they are dependent on fossil biomass and so on. Of course, we talk about energy sustainability. We always feel that we have a better system. We want to have a luxurious system. But ultimately, if you don't fulfill the requirement, that means, you know that, because I'm a mechanical engineer, I give my students this example. You see, in India, if you take some 50, 60 years, 20 years back, you hardly find one or two car manufacturing companies. But now you see every, almost whatever you can find in the world, you can find in India. And with different models, different things. We will try to, if we can afford, we can buy a car like this. But ultimately, it cannot run on its own. It requires some fuel. And that fuel we import. And if there is some problem with the fuel, we may have to land up like this. We have to sit somewhere here and then drive, because when fuel is important. So therefore, energy sustainability is most important. We have like this bluish color earth, but what indiscriminate usage of fossil fuels, it may result in like this. We are imbalancing the system. If you overload any system in any environment, it highly imbalances the system. We should not afford to imbalance the system like this. So what should be the solution? See, here we have sources, energy sources. These sources are finite, and you can use these sources without technology. No technology is required to use like this. But these resources will be exhausted over a period of time. You have to keep these resources for the future generation. So the what we call sustainability and so on. What one should do is you develop a technology. Develop a technology and keep these resources for the future generation. You can use these resources judiciously. Then only you can keep and attain any sustainability. So therefore, what is this technology? What is this technology? The technology is not stored. It is the technology which caters the needs of energy needs of the society. So those technologies are nothing but the renewable energy technology. So the future generation says that there's only one earth we have to take care of, both environment point of view, energy point of view. We have to see that it's your money, your environment, your mission. You have to conserve your earth. So what is the solution? The energy sustainability can be attained in a threefold: energy efficiency, proper mix of energy sources, and of course make use of renewable energy sources. The energy efficiency is of course a shorter, it's a continuous process, and it can give a short term results, but proper mix up, because wherever you have energy, you try to mix them and make it hybridize. Hybrid is the energy sources, try to cater the requirements, so that it may be a medium term, but definitely the long term solution is renewable energy solution. That is what we call effective energy system or sources. Now, the modern or innovative renewable energy sources are technologies are required, and they have to be modern, and they have to be innovative, and they have to be local, indigenous. So, the solution is only for the present energy and environment. Only solution is that this develop modern, innovative renewable energy in local indigenous technologies. And these renewable energy technologies can untangle triple bond, development, energy, environment, which we call as sustainability. Once you have a renewable energy technology here, your system here, if you set up somewhere in a rural area or urban area, what happens is the technology makes security of energy, because it's your energy, your sun, your wind, no one can stop it. Even if your fossil fuels can be stopped by the suppliers, but sun cannot be stopped by anyone. So therefore, if you have your own technology, you can. There is a security of supply, no one can stop, and in the process of developing or producing energy, you get some local improving living of standards, like economic development, and of course these renewable energy technologies are environmentally benign, so therefore the most promising technologies rather. They ensure the development in perpetuity, environmental benefits, energy security and self-reliance, and social benefits. And in fact, there is a significant growth in renewable energy installations in India. This is one of such things, and wind is a mainly major renewable energy in India. But nowadays, the solar is gaining momentum, both photovoltaics and thermal, because this cascading of energy is also very important. See, if you have higher energy, use for higher purposes, high quality purpose. If you have lower energy, you try to cascade, you can bring down, grade it down and use it for some other applications. In fact, there are significant emissions in India. Relatively per capita emissions are less as compared to the other countries. And there are a lot of goals for low carbon economy in India. Of course, to reduce that, there are several policies. Maybe you may be more aware of these policies. I have listed several policies here to tackle the environmental issues. And if you take renewable energy technologies for energy supply, there are wide variety of generally renewable means solar. All other renewables are manifestation of solar energy. You name wind, biomass, and all these are manifestation of solar. So therefore, solar is the renewable energy. So you have a wide variety of applications. You can use it for various things. And a typical solar system works like this. You have a cycle. So energy comes from the sun and it's transformed into some other forms of energies, and then ultimately used for both power generation. The most important thing in nowadays gaining momentum is this energy storage. It can be either electrical storage or thermal storage, that depends on that, because the energy storage makes the system more reliable and more affordable and all. So therefore, a typical solar system looks like this. There are major for electrical energy system. You have two routes, the photovoltaics, which we call as a direct energy conversion system. It converts into electrical energy. The other one is convert solar into heat and use it for this. This is a decentralized and local thing and rooftop type of things. They're modular systems, whereas this is a large scale systems where you can implement large scale operations. We are at IIT, I want to give some indigenous technology what we are doing at IIT Madras. We are working on all almost all types of renewable energies and mainly technology development. We are working on solar thermal, solar photovoltaics, CPV, concentrating photovoltaics. You know, if you concentrate energy onto the PV, it increases the efficiency, but simultaneously the cell thermal management is another issue and so on. We are also working on managing the other applications of renewables like water. Water is another major issue, portable for water production and so on. So a typical technology, because I have to give some technology flavor. This is one such technology, which is, these are solar concentrators which are located in our department in our lab. So these are a couple of systems which concentrate solar energy and produce high temperature heat, and they are developed for in order to attain higher efficiencies, so that they can be taken into the market. And there are several companies, companies have taken forward these technologies to the market. I'll show you them. This is another view of this. We are working also on desalination and power generation, CPV and so on. It looks like this is a system which produces very high temperature heat that can be used for process heat, generally leather industries, textile industries and so on. You can use the heat directly, and you can also install this as a big power plant. And in fact, we have come up with an atlas across India how these technologies are more feasible or less feasible. We have come up with three criteria. One is this green color is wherever you install such system, they are viable, and the blue colors are conditionally viable, and some areas even they are not viable. And these are the companies which they have taken up our technology to the market. There are, especially for process heat, pharmaceutical industries, they have taken this, and we can go for power generation. This is a large scale test facility for CSP power plants, and this is one such power plant is located in Coimbatore and so on. And this is photovoltaics development of a tracking system to make this system more viable and increase the efficiency of system. Some technological component, and this is a concentrating photovoltaics where you can produce, it's a cogeneration system. It produces heat as well as electricity. Heat can be used for hot water applications, desalination, and air conditioning application. Electricity is for, of course, you know. This is a typical cell. It's a self-representation cell where you have a higher efficiency, even 30-40% and so on. And the heat can also be used for various applications. We have developed a system for desalination and effluent treatment. In environment is a major problem in Tamil Nadu, in Tirupur district. You know that it's a largest textile hub, and these textile industries are just rejecting their effluents into the atmosphere, which is you know, beyond the standard. So therefore, many of them have closed. So we have come up with some solution so that you can treat the effluent easily by using solar energy. So this is one such system which is placed in Tirupur. And the another important system is, this is an integrated system. The solution for the present energy environment is one of them. This is one of them. And this is an integrated system which includes both. It's a proper mix of energy sources, both solar and biomass. We have one system developed to cater the needs of a completely decentralized system. It is located in West Bengal, close to Shantiniketan. we have chosen one tribal village. There is no grid to the system, no electricity, nothing, no energy. We have come up with a biomass and solar integrated system which caters electrical needs 24 hours round the clock, plus cooking gas, plus water, and of course local medical health center and health center, school, and some small community hall. The location of this system is somewhere here in West Bengal, close to Chandni Ketan. And it primarily uses four types of system: CPV, digester, then biomass digester, and hydrogen electrolyzer. It's an integrated, completely integrated system to cater the needs of that village. So it works almost 24 hours. The typical system configuration, I don't know whether you will be able to understand. See, it gives essentially, you see, electricity, cooking gas, and there is a local health care in this. The system configuration looks like this. Maybe it's a more of a technical side, it's a design system. And a typical system looks like this. You know, this concentrated solar radiation, we have a biomass system at the dome, and it integrates that. In conclusion of my talk is, you know that an integrated system, integrated renewable energy system can be the solution for both energy sustainability and of course environmental sustainability. But the thing is, ultimately with a tagline for indigenous technology development. As long as you don't have indigenous technology, you may not be able to cater the requirement. So therefore, an integrated system can give you the solution. Thank you so much.